Hello, and welcome to this video about using Linux ethtool and the U-Boot MII tools to examine Ethernet link status. This is the first debug step for when no network activity is detected. Before network data can pass, an Ethernet link must be established between the two link partners. The link status for a MAC interface must be detected by each partner. This video will show how to examine that link status. Video, we will use the Linux utility ethtool to look at if an Ethernet link has been detected with a link partner. This is the first debug step for understanding why there is not any network traffic, which is usually detected when a device does not get an IP address or a ping command fails. This video is mostly targeted to custom board developers who are trying to bring up their network interfaces for the first time. Also in this video, we will look at the U-Boot utility MII tools, which is the equivalent of the Linux ethtool. A lot of the same information that ethtool provides is also going to be found with MII tools, such as link status and line mode duplicity, and whether auto-negotiation completed. Link establishment between two link partners happens after the PHY on your board has been released from reset and latches the requested modes and performs the link auto-negotiation with a link partner who is at the other end of the network cable. A very important thing to note is that this auto-negotiation link establishment activity happens independent of and way before any driver initialization. Now we will talk about the partners forming an Ethernet link. So the rest of this video is going to be mostly talking about the establishment between two link partners, a connection. So we need kind of, I think, a basic definition to talk about what an Ethernet link is. An Ethernet link is established and also referred to as detected between two link partners and only two when there is an agreement on line speed and line duplex mode. The picture here is kind of showing the connection between two link partners. On the left is a BeagleBone Black, and on the right is a link partner. This link partner could be a switch, it could be another BeagleBone Black, it could be a PC, so long as there's another Ethernet-capable device here. The BeagleBone Black board is capable of 10 100 megabits in full and half duplex, and in the example here, the link partner can be capable of 10 100 and 1 gig megabits per second, full and half duplex. Through a process called auto-negotiation, the link would be established between these two link partners when they detect the best speed and duplex mode between the two partners. In this example, it would be 100 megabits and full duplex. Again, I would like to emphasize this link establishment happens independent of any driver being loaded on either device. It happens typically when the PHY is brought out of reset, it tries to look for a link partner, and goes through this auto-negotiation process. Another point to be made is that custom boards that are being brought up for the first time can have an issue here. As mentioned earlier, there is not any PHY driver necessary to establish a link. If the auto-negotiation is failing to establish a link, it can be due to a hardware issue with the PHY on the custom board. So as mentioned in the title of this video, there is a first step for looking at network issues. We established earlier that a link connection is between two link partners, and they must have an established link. Whether bringing up a new custom board or using an existing EVM, without an Ethernet link detection, no network data will pass. So the first debug step is check the Ethernet link status. By the time Linux is running, any attempts at link establishment has already been attempted. Remember, no driver interaction is required. In Linux, there is a utility called ethtool that allows status reporting and low-level control of the Ethernet interface. In addition to ethtool, there is a link light on the connector, and that's shown at the picture at right. This is also the first indicator of link status, but only if the connector has lights that are hooked up. Looking at the picture and the box there indicating the green light is the link detected light and also the activity light on the BeagleBone Black. So if this light is green or is flashing, that means you have a valid Ethernet link or a link detected, which is what you want to see. So this next slide is more about when bringing up a new board. So before we can use the ethtool utility, the PHY must be identified in the boot log. The main reason for this is that the processor needs to be able to use the MDIO bus to communicate with the PHY. In the slide here, we have a slight snippet capture of both the boot log and the schematic of the BeagleBone Black. As the kernel is booting, it's going to go out and try and find the MDIO bus, and then it's going to try to identify any PHYs that are on that bus. And the one line that's highlighted here is you can see that there is a PHY with address 0 responding on the MDIO bus, and it's been identified as an SMSC PHY driver, LANs 8710. This corresponds to the schematic snippet saying, okay, we have a SMSC PHY 8710 that's in the schematic, and now we've identified that both the boot log and the schematic match up. So this is a good indication that the kernel is able to communicate with the PHY over the MDIO bus And now we can use ethtool to look at what the link status may be. Now we're going to look at the actual ethtool output when there is no link detection. So when there is no link detection, it could be from a variety of things, such as the two files are just aren't able to auto-negotiate, to even up to a cable being cut or just not even connected. So the video here is a Minicom output connected to a big old blown black, and I'm going to use the ethtool for eth0 since there's only one interface on the board. So when you're using ethtool, there are three things that you want to look at. You want to see if first off, if the link's been detected. As you can see at the bottom, it has not. Then you want to see what the speed is, which you can see is 10 megabits per second, and you want to see what the line duplex is. In this case, it is half. When you see this combination of 10 megabits per second, half duplex, and no link, there is a good chance that auto negotiation failed. So let's examine a little closer what we're seeing here in the ethtool output. The auto negotiation process is going to start out at the max speed available for the PHY and duplex mode. So in this case, we would start at 100 base T full, and then we would move down from there. The PHY is going to try to negotiate all that. And as you can see at the end here of the negotiation process is that we ended up with a speed of 10 megabits per second and half duplex. This is the worst of the possible modes supported by this PHY. So at the end of the auto negotiation process, the PHY has ended up with a speed of 10 megabits per second, half duplex, and no link detected. 9 times out of 10, this is not going to be a valid link unless you're connected to a hub. But as long as there's no link detected, no data will pass, as the PHY driver has indicated there's no link available, and the higher level Ethernet drivers will not pass data to a PHY that's reporting no link. So the next step would be is to debug while there's no link detected. Now we will look at using ethtool and what a link detection looks like. So again, we're going to pick up where we left off in that we have a Minicom connected to a BeagleBone Black. We're going to plug in the cable and we're going to see the link gets established. And after the link is established, we get our prompt back and we're going to run ethtool again. And now at the bottom, you see a link is detected. So looking at the three things I mentioned before, we want to look at the link mode, the duplicity mode, and the speed. So we have a detected link. We can see that the speed is 100 megabits per second and we have a full duplex line. This is a link that will allow data to pass. With a detected link, the drivers are now fully initialized and be able to send data on this Ethernet link. So it's like another step of kind of tying everything together. With the boot log output, you can see that PHY0 is what was identified in the boot log. And if you look at the PHY address here in the ethtool output, you can also see that it is too also 0. So in summary, this is what a good link looks like. Now let's look at the MII tool that comes with U-Boot. And in the same type of order we did last time for ethtool, we're going to start with a no link detection. So again, we're looking at a video of a Minicom output that is connected to a BeagleBone Black. We're going to type in MII dump 0 and 0, which means we're looking at PHY0 address 0, which is the one of the MII registers. And then we're going to also look at, again, PHY0 and address 1. So the MII tool is allowing us to dump out the first couple of registers here of the PHY. These are standard definition registers, and they are usually defined within the PHY datasheet. So looking at the second dump of PHY0 address 1 of MII registers, you can look down there, you can see that link status is 0, and that the line supports auto-negotiation, but auto-negotiation did not complete. So this is an indication that we do not have a link. So since auto negotiation did not complete, we know we have an issue between the two link partners. Next, we're going to look at MII tool and link detection. Like in the previous slide, we're now going to hook up the cable and we're going to run the MII tool dump for registers 0 and 1 and look at what a link status detected looks like. So again, here's our video output, our Minicom output showing on the BeagleBone Black. And we're going to enter in MII dump 0 and MII dump 1. All right, so looking at register 1 down there with link status, we can see that it now shows a 1. And if we look up there to A/N, which is on a negotiation, by the way, it shows it's complete. And you can see that the duplex is now showing full and we have a link speed of 100 megabits. So in summary for this slide, this is what you want to see: a link status and on negotiation complete and the full duplex. So next, let's look at some conclusions to this video. The first step is to use ethtool to make sure a link is detected when looking for reasons why there's not any network traffic. On new boards, make sure the PHY identified with the MAC interface is showing up in the boot log or dmessage output. Typically on new board designs, when no link is detected, even though the Linux PHY driver is loaded and communicating, the PHY could be in an unknown state and not capable of either negotiating with a link partner or passing network traffic. If no link is detected, please consider reviewing the PHY datasheet and contacting the PHY manufacturer for guidance on how to proceed with debug. Another few quick simple tips is to make sure that the Ethernet connectors are actually firmly seated together so that the plug is actually all the way into the socket. Make sure that the link partner is powered up and is healthy. And consider replacing the cable, because sometimes cables do go bad for a variety of reasons. So that concludes this video, so thank you for taking a look. Here are some additional links on training available from Texas Instruments.